Hi.
And welcome to this video on non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and their effects. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs are most often referred to as NSAIDs. NSAIDs have anti-inflammatory effects that are similar to those of steroids, but without some of the serious adverse effects. Indications for NSAIDs include mild to moderate pain, fever, various ophthalmic uses, primary dysmenorrhea, tendinitis and bursitis, ankylosing spondylitis, rheumatoid arthritis, juvenile rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis, and gout, specifically acute gouty arthritis. NSAIDs act by inhibiting the enzyme cyclooxygenase, or COX. Cyclooxygenase enzymes include two isoenzymes, cyclooxygenase 1, or COX-1, and cyclooxygenase 2, or COX-2. NSAIDs inhibit both COX-1 and COX-2, or COX-2 alone. Cyclooxygenase acts by converting arachidonic acid, which is released from phospholipids in cell membranes, to prostaglandins and related compounds, which are necessary to carry out many bodily processes. COX-1 is found in tissues throughout the body where it has primarily beneficial functions, such as protecting gastric mucosa, supporting renal function, promoting platelet aggregation, and promoting macrophage differentiation. Thus, inhibiting COX-1 does not relieve pain or inflammation. COX-2, however, has primarily inflammatory functions. COX-2 is active primarily at the site of injuries, where it mediates the inflammatory response, and in the brain, where it responds to injuries by promoting vasodilation in inflammation, sensitizing receptors to painful stimuli, mediating the fever response, and mediating the perception of pain. Thus, inhibiting COX-2 relieves pain and inflammation. However, in addition to the harmful processes, COX-2 also has some beneficial processes, promoting renal function and perfusion, and promoting vasodilation, or preventing vasoconstriction. Most first-generation NSAIDs are non-selective cyclooxygenase inhibitors, meaning that they inhibit both COX-1 and COX-2. Some later generations are selective for COX-2 only. The most commonly used NSAIDs are non-specific, especially the older drugs such as ibuprofen, naproxen, and indomethacin. Specific COX-2 inhibitors include celecoxib, or Celebrex, meloxicam, and diclofenac, a topical preparation. Most NSAIDs are available by prescription, but some, such as ibuprofen and naproxen, are available in lesser doses over the counter. So what happens when COX-1 and COX-2 are inhibited? Well, let's look first at the effects of an NSAID on COX-1. Instead of protecting the gastric mucosa, ulceration and bleeding occurs. Instead of supporting renal function, renal impairment occurs. Instead of promoting platelet aggregation, antiplatelet action occurs. And instead of promoting macrophage differentiation, macrophages develop a more inflammatory state. While most of the changes resulting from COX-1 inhibition are harmful, the antiplatelet action may be beneficial because it can reduce the risk of myocardial infarction and stroke. This is the reason that aspirin, first-generation NSAID, is usually avoided for control of pain and inflammation, but used in low doses for its antiplatelet action. Now let's take a look at the effects of an NSAID on COX-2. Instead of promoting vasodilation, it causes vasoconstriction, which reduces swelling but also increases the risk of myocardial infarction and stroke. Instead of sensitizing receptors to painful stimuli and mediating the perception of pain, it reduces pain. Instead of promoting renal function and perfusion, it impairs renal function. Most of the adverse effects associated with NSAIDs result from COX-1 inhibition, especially their effects on the GI system. While most therapeutic effects result from COX-2 inhibition, selective COX-2 inhibitors also pose risks. Some of the early COX-2 inhibitors, such as rofecoxib or Vioxx, were taken off the market because they doubled the risk of heart attack and stroke. Adverse effects of NSAIDs may include gas, stomach pain, nausea, vomiting, gastric ulcers, GI bleeding, hemorrhage or diarrhea, tinnitus and possible hearing loss, headache and dizziness, allergic reactions, sometimes as serious as anaphylaxis, acute renal failure, hepatic toxicity, heart failure, myocardial infarction or stroke, and altered hemostasis that is associated with platelets. A range of NSAIDs is now available in both non-specific and COX-2 specific formulations. So while one may be ineffective, another may be effective. While aspirin is an NSAID, it differs from other NSAIDs in that its effects on COX-1 and COX-2 are irreversible. In other words, COX-1 and COX-2 remain inhibited until new COX-1 and COX-2 are synthesized. The effects of other NSAIDs on COX-1 and COX-2 are reversible and decrease along with the blood titer. Contraindications to the use of NSAIDs include pregnancy at 20 weeks or later, risk of low amniotic fluid, breastfeeding, anticoagulant therapy, inflammatory bowel disease, uncontrolled hypertension, sensitivity to specific ingredients within the drug, and the preoperative period. Generally, NSAIDs should be avoided for 1 week prior to surgery to reduce the risk of bleeding. Additional contraindications include a history of coronary artery bypass, transient ischemic attack, stroke, and heart disease, and a history of cirrhotic liver disease, heart disease, and renal disease. NSAIDs are the most commonly prescribed medications for pain and inflammation, accounting for up to 10% of all prescriptions. However, every year, thousands of people die from adverse effects, most often GI bleeding. Because some NSAIDs are inexpensive and available over the counter, people often view them as safer than they actually are. It's critical to stress the importance of following directions and limiting use to no more than 3 days for fever or 10 days for pain, unless monitored by a physician. Thanks for watching, and happy studying.